Sorry. That's why white people can't talk about race, because we always end up on the dick thing. I'm sorry. Just a thing. But I do think it's important to tell people about race, to talk about it. You gotta tell your kids about race. If you don't tell your kids about race, it fucks them up later in life. And I'll admit this to you, I'll admit this now, because I grew up in this tiny little town. It was an all-white town, and it wasn't all-white by law or anything. It just happened to be all-white. There was no signs up. There's just only white people in my shitty town. And so I didn't meet anybody who looked any different than me for 20 years. Nobody even told me accents exist. Nobody told me that people talk differently. I only met people who looked and sounded like me. And so this is something that I'm ashamed of. I'm not proud of this, but this is something about me racially. I'm not proud of it, like I said, but I'm coming to terms with the fact that I might live to be 100 years old. I'm never going to find an over-the-top Asian accent not funny. I'm sorry. I know that's not okay, but every time I hear hero, I fucking laugh my face off. And I can justify it a little bit. Let me justify it. I grew up in this all-white town. Like I said, nobody told me accents even exist. I didn't know people talked any differently than me. And I didn't meet an Asian person until I was 18 years old. Me and two of my friends, we went from my shitty little town to the city closest to us, and we got in a cab, and the cab driver was an Asian dude. And we were so young and white and stupid, we were kind of like proud of ourselves for hanging out with a dude. We're like, look at us, big city, hanging out with an Asian man. We thought we were really cool, but we didn't know what to say. We were nervous, so it was like 30 seconds of awkward silence. And then the cab driver, just to break the silence, I guess, he looks over at my friend, and my friend's wearing a pair of flip-flops. It's like a cold day, but he's got sandals on. And the cab driver yells this. And again, keep in mind, nobody's ever told us that accents exist. I don't know anybody talks any different. And this is not going to sound okay, but this is a bang-on impression. I swear to God, the cab driver looks at my friend's flip-flops, and he just yells at him. He goes, "Why you wear open toes and no?" And we all went, "What the fuck was that? That's not how we're used to people talking." And we start laughing. We start uncontrollable laughing. Like, you know that laughter, you know you're not supposed to be laughing, but you just can't stop laughing. And we couldn't stop, because every minute and a half, this son of a bitch would go, "Why you raff? Ha ha ha." We're like, fucking stop. Stop it. That's not fair. It's not fair. Try not to laugh. We laughed the whole way there. We laughed the whole trip. We get to the destination. We just give him all our money. Let's just take this. This is blood money. We don't want it. And we get out. And we're laughing about it. We're laughing about it. And that's not okay. But in our defense, open toe sandal is such a beautifully specific phrase. And in that accent, it's just so wonderfully sing-songy. Just open toe sandal. It's fucking beautiful. But the messed up thing, the reason why you have to tell your kids about different races, is when we heard him talk like that, we never once thought anything racial. We never once thought, oh, that's what an Asian accent sounds like. We just thought, oh, this dickhead's got a speech impediment. And it's hilarious. So we were walking around our town just yelling that for a whole year. A whole year. We never said hello. Every time we saw each other on the street, we'd just be like, open toes and out. And he'd be like, open toes and out to you too, sir. And we'd have a little laugh. And it was a full year before somebody was like, you know that's super racist, right? And we're like, no, it's just this dude with a speech impediment. And he's like, no, that's an Asian accent. We're like, what? We're like, well, why did he say open toe sandal? Like, that's such a silly phrase. It's like, you probably said open toe sandal, because it's super hard to say flip-flop in an Asian accent. We were like, frippa-froppa. Oh, fuck, it really is. Holy shit, that's... Oh, man, that's not okay. Turns out we were racist. And I thought that was the end of it. I thought that was the end of it. We're almost done, I promise, this bit. I thought that was the end of it until 5 years later. 5 years after that date, I was back in that same city with my girlfriend at the time, who I fucking hated. Just a fact, she hated me, I hated her, we dated for years. She just hated each other. But we're in that city, we're in a hotel, and we call for a taxi. And so we're standing up front of the hotel, just waiting for the taxi, just hating each other. And the taxi pulls up, it was 5 years later, it's the same Asian dude. And I got so excited, like I was seeing a celebrity or something. I like nudged my girlfriend, I'm like, oh my God, it's open toe sandal, that's incredible. And she was like, I don't know what that means. And I was like, will you just fucking die already? Jesus Christ. Why do you have to ruin everything fun? Jesus. I yell open toe sandal literally every day. You know what that means. I know you know what that means. And she was like, oh, that's racist. You're racist. I'm like, I'm not racist. I thought it was a speech impediment, and then it got out of control, and it's too late now. I can't not find it funny. And I'm like, open toe sandal is a funny phrase. I'm going to get in the cab. We're going to get in the cab. I'm going to get him to say open toe sandal. You're going to laugh, and that'll prove that I'm not racist. And so we get in the cab, and she was right. I was super racist. It wasn't even the same Asian dude. Different guy. His name was Kevin. What can I say? I was racist. So I got to tell your kids about race. You got to learn, because otherwise you learn the hard way, and it's awkward, man.